Well, it's India's premier investigating agency currently focusing on a case that has gripped the nation for almost 4 weeks. But the CBI took the man who could have some answers into who killed Aarushi Talwar to Bangalore for scientific tests without any proper paperwork.
Well, after the laboratory turned them away, they quickly went to court and got the relevant papers. Not just that, they are also accused of keeping Krishna, the Talwar's compounder, in illegal detention.
The CBI has detained this man since the 3rd of June without a legal arrest. On record, Krishna, the compounder of Dr. Rajesh Talwar, has been declared neither a suspect nor a witness. But after 2 rounds of lie detector tests, the agency wanted him to go through narco analysis or brain mapping as well.
The scientific tests are being conducted as per the consent given by him and as per the various provisions of the law.
What they didn't have is a court order, which experts say is mandatory.
Even where court grants permission, whether an accused can be taken for narco test is a question which is still to be decided. Whether an accused can be forced to be a witness against himself, because that is the end result of a narco test.
Sources say the Bangalore lab that was supposed to conduct the test refused to do so in the absence of a court order. By evening, an embarrassed CBI got the permission and the officer in charge of investigations took it to Bangalore, after which the test began.
In the past, the CBI has always maintained that they are against invasive procedures like narco analysis or brain mapping, but perhaps it's a sign of CBI's desperation because they have very little evidence in the Noida double murder case. In New Delhi, Sunetra Chaudhary for NDTV.